Centre in sunny Auckland for the second time. We're here to headline for the very first time our own festival, which we're really excited about. We've come a really long way. This is just before we're about to release The Darkest Road, which is going to be our second album. We're really excited. It's a 14-track CD. It's the follow-up of our debut album, Dead or Alive. So basically we're here and it's going to be a huge show.
Yeah, we went through, we've been through a few singers now, and we've always strived for a certain sound and a style that we, it took us a while to find, but yeah, we knew with this kid that he had the voice. It took us a few years, but yeah, he had the voice, and he's a handful sometimes, old Reese, I'll give you that, but man, his voice is like, it's the shit. It's, yeah, you gotta love it. I mean, like, the next album coming out, you gotta love this shit, I guarantee you that.
Reese is a fucking party animal. He loves anything about the party life. Girls, he loves getting pissed.
This is my life, E-R-I, through the eyes of the enemy. This is your time.
I've cracked, I'm back at this. I hacked out of my straitjacket, attacked it and had to snap it, similar to a super crocodile. Wait, no I didn't, but still I'm not still. I'm sitting, I'm running hands-free down the street, bare feet, I'm a Bluetooth T-Mobile star. Wait.
To a life, it's what dreams are made of. You got, think of, what's the best way to describe a tour? Well, you got a van. So think of like a hot greenhouse incubation sort of tank. 10 dudes, farts, BO, dirty clothes. Yeah, like long traveling, but you know, it makes it all worth it when you get to the shows and see everybody's faces when they listen to your music. It's really good.
Styx is the grandpa. He's just all about the yeah, oh, nah, yeah, nah.
This is Styx. Yeah, nah. Alright, eh? That's Styx to a T, that's all you need to know.
Styx is the epitome of opposites. He is double kicking like a hummingbird, yet he can't talk more than 20 words a minute. So you work that one out.
Yeah, man, he's the original dude from A Breach of Silence. It's his baby. We all kind of know that. We all are part of Breach of Silence. But yeah, it was me and Cozzy back way back in the beginning, and he knew exactly what he wanted to do. He knew the sound he wanted. He knows what he wants in life, pretty much. And that's what A Breach of Silence is. When you hear the crux of it, that's what Cozzy really desires in metal. And it vouches for us too. That's what we really desire in metal.
He always seems to get sick. And yeah, he's always sick on tour and he can't carry shit. And then he's lying in bed and he doesn't come out and party. Cozzy is, the annoying one.
K-Dab, Kerrod. The youngest of the band, the baby. He's an okay guitarist. He shreds a little bit.
Kerrod's my bro. He's my bro town.
I love that guy. We hang out. He's a great person to be around. He shreds the guitar. He's amazing. He's a good composer and a great songwriter.
And he keeps the shit at the front together. And I can vouch for that because I see the backs of these guys' heads every fucking night when we play a show. But puts 100% in everything he does. He's helped shape the sound of what A Breach of Silence is on the next album. Like, you guys will definitely hear it from Dead or Alive to The Darkest Road. You'll definitely hear different influences coming in, and Kerrod's got a lot to do with that.
Some kind of medieval warrior looking guy.
He lives the dream, can do lots of little high falsettos, good times.
Blairzy runs this shit, basically. He is the father of the band. Like, he rings me at 5 o'clock to make sure I'm getting to the airport at 7. Like, he's the organizer of the band, which keeps us going, so.
Blair, he fucking snores a lot. And it tends to get on a lot of people's nerves. He is a bit of a show pony too, but that's what makes him so good, you know? Like, he's up the front belting those songs out. Man, he's 80s, so you got to have a bit of shit about you if you get to sing 80s stuff. And just look at his hair, that's all I have to say.
It's absolutely incredible to see kids at shows singing back the lyrics that we've written and for the songs that we do, and they know the actual parts to the songs. It's incredible. We've travelled Australia a few times, and seeing people from across the other side of the country singing back the words to our songs is amazing, I think. It's one of the highlights. It's the reason why I do this. So.
Hey, so we just got off stage in Auckland. Fantastic. The room was amazing. Auckland is like our second home. We love New Zealand. We love everybody here. We love playing new songs for you guys. You guys are sick. You guys are fucking awesome. And keep rocking out, man.
Yeah. Wow! Auckland's like a fucking second home to us. You guys fucking were amazing tonight, so thank you so much. It's been great.